for your soul has a deeper knowledge of who you are, a deeper knowledge of your plan, of your commitment, of your cooperation within this world. For each and every soul, dear ones, comes into this world with certain ideas, ideas of that which it wishes to create. Some have called them agreements, dear one, but we simply call them intentions, for the soul intends to create life in a certain way, and yet is not bound by these thoughts and intentions, for the soul simply tries its best to bring about that which it desires to create, based upon the highest good for all life. And if a soul cannot complete its desired mission, there is no suffering, and there is no pain, for the soul understands the greater oneness of all life, and understands the experience of eternal love. And so, dear one, the soul simply intends. The soul simply holds within itself the desire and intention to bring change within this world, to improve it, and to improve its own understanding of who it is, the power it possesses, the oneness that it truly is. And so, dear ones, each and every one of you desires two things. One is to improve the quality of life upon this world, for the world is struggling. Humanity is struggling in their decisions of that which they are desiring to create. For the majority, dear ones, of human consciousness embodied within the material world, the majority are not living in harmony with their own higher knowing, but instead they are trapped in a socially conditioned mind, creating chaos within their bodies, creating disease due to their own internal suffering, due to their emotional suffering, their mental confusion, and their lack of living in harmony with the material earth. And so, dear one, humanity is largely struggling, yet souls continue to incarnate here and now to bring upliftment, to bring new knowledge, to create world peace. And so, dear one, each and every soul desires the highest outcome for all of life upon this planet. Peace, cooperation, unconditional love, unconditional support of each other as we learn and grow through our choices, as we struggle and fail, and yet rise again to teach ourselves more fully about what life is. Each and every soul, dear one, desires to create a better home within this world. And then, dear one, the second desire of every soul is that of knowledge, for existing within the soul is the mystery. The mystery of that which is possible, the mystery of the future that it wishes to create, the mystery of wondering, how powerful am I? How can I express myself in the image of the Creator? For you see, dear one, each soul is learning. While cooperating with each other to create a world, each soul is learning about what it has as an individual aspect of the creative consciousness. Each soul is expressing itself in a way that provides higher learning and higher knowledge. Each soul is expressing itself in a way that brings it to a greater state of love and power. For you must understand, dear one, that the power of creation, that the power of life, is in fact the energy of love. The two are truly one. For it is the energy of bliss, the energy of happiness. It is the energy in which all of life is being created. For creation is the ultimate miracle, the ultimate celebration, the greatest gift. And so, dear one, you, as an individualized aspect of this universal creative consciousness, are the gift that the Supreme Consciousness has given itself. For you see, dear one, the Supreme Consciousness is creating an experience, and this experience is the infinite division of itself into numerous perspectives, and infinite co-creative potentials. And so, dear one, all of the creative power the infinite, the unimaginable, the uncalculable creative power of this source has been split infinitely and never reduced, and is expressing itself in each and every one of you, in each and every rock and tree, in each and every space and moment in time. All the creative consciousness, all the power of creation is reflected in each and every aspect of manifest form. And so, dear one, it is a gift. It is a gift that the Supreme Consciousness has given itself in creating you, all of you. And yet through this creation, you are truly never separate from the consciousness that is creating, for you are this. And you have been given all of the potential that this supreme creative consciousness has. For there is no limit. The only thing limiting you, dear one, is how much you understand yourself. Can you understand this, dear ones? You are here to learn about who you are, to create your life in harmony with your own desire to gain greater knowledge, to gain more love. For we are all trying to understand what life is, and the power of life is this love. So knowledge of life and the experience of greater love go hand in hand, for the two are truly one. We seek to understand why this is, what this is, who we are. And we ultimately, dear one, come back to the primal creative energy of life, the experience of supreme divine love. And now, dear one, let us bring this back to you. Now that you have a better understanding of yourself in relationship to the greater all that is, to your own soul's purpose for incarnating, let us bring it back to you. For each and every soul has a desire of why it chose to come, and each and every desire holds a purpose in helping the soul better understand who they are as an aspect of creation. And yet as we look out, dear ones, and see the souls upon this earth, we see the pathways that they intend to create to bring themselves to this higher learning are all unique. Each pathway is individual. Each soul has a desire of its own, has a desire to create experiences based upon its own previous understanding and based upon its own knowledge of that which it is. And so, dear ones, each and every you has a purpose, a goal, an intention that you have created and that you have brought forth into this world. Now, dear one, it is important to understand that the way to connect to this deeper intention is through the doorway of the soul within you. It is, dear one, the spiritual heart center, the deepest energy center of your manifest self in connection to the eternal soul that you are.